Wars, starvation, diseases, natural disasters. Christians all over the earth not only knew that such events would take place, but that their intensity would increase near the end of this world. There will also be persecutions, hatred, betrayals, lack of love, the appearing of the abomination of desolation, false Christs and false prophets. All this while we, like Noah, commit all we are and have to preach the last message to this world. During these times, whoever chooses to follow Jesus may suffer in different ways. They may lose their lives. They may be burdened with sicknesses or heavy financial constraint. There will be a day when we won't be able to buy or sell anything. But when these things begin to happen, look up and lift up your heads, because your redemption draws near. We are told not to be afraid. God promises to be with us always, to be our refuge and strength, and to provide for our most essential needs. Bread will be given him, his water will be sure. Should then Christians tithe and bring promise, regular and systematic offerings, during those challenging times when they do not receive any income or increase? No. The Bible is clear that tithe and promise should be given only from income or increase previously received from God, as regularly as we receive them. It is not something we do in order to be blessed or protected, but in recognition of a blessing. It is a response, not a prelude. So if you want to acknowledge God as the source of all your blessings, worship Him every time He blesses you with an income or increase through your tithes and promise. The Lord also will be a refuge for the oppressed, a refuge in times of trouble. And those who know your name will put their trust in you. For you, Lord, have not forsaken those who seek you. Psalm 9, 9 through 10.